once upon a time, once upon a day of all the good old days in the year, on Christmas Eve Day, a busy man strode busily down a not-so-busy street. No ordinary time, nor day, nor man. His name was Scrooge. No warmth could warm him, no wintry weather chill him. In short, Ebenezer Scrooge was...
I'm one mean son of a bitch!
Yes. Indeed, Scrooge was one mean...
Well, who asked you anyway?
I'm the narrator.
Well, narrate then, for crying out loud! I don't understand why I have to go to...
Ebenezer Scrooge worked as a master control operator at a small...
Senior master control operator.
Senior master control operator at a small local television station. And although it was Christmas Eve, this night was like any other in television land, and Mr. Scrooge had to work. A lonely man on his way to a lonely job.
Get out of here, kid!
Yes, Scrooge's heart was as dark as pitch. As dark as that merry Christmas Eve when he arrived at his appointed place at the appointed time. It seemed not even the warmth of Christmas could enlighten old Scrooge.
Merry Christmas and God bless, Mr. Scrooge.
What's so good about it, Mr. Ratchet? We're working, aren't we?
That's Cratchit, not Ratchet.
Bob Cratchit worked in Master Control as Mr. Scrooge's loyal apprentice. This night, as was their custom on holidays, Scrooge would relieve Cratchit for the night shift, to be relieved in turn for sign-on the next morning. But the next morning was Christmas.
What? It's cold
Mr.
outside.
Mr. Scrooge, if I could just come in a little late tomorrow. It's just the one day of the year.
Christmas? Bah humbug. Just be at your post at sign-on on time.
But it is Christmas, Mr. Scrooge. You must understand. It's not for me. It's for Tiny Tim.
That's right, Scrooge. You have to give her Christmas Day off. She worked the night before. We're talking. Turn around working Christmas Day. That's double time and a half. Could be a CDO. Could be triple time and a half. Meal encroachments? You bet. $6.50 for the first meal, $8.50 for the second meal. Good.
Listen, Cratchit, I don't make merry on Christmas, and I don't support idle people like Tiny Tim. You be there at 6 a.m. for sign-on, or there'll be a letter on your file.
Yes, Mr. Scrooge. Whatever you say, Mr. Scrooge.
I know Roy Gardner.
I don't care, Dad. We're not taking this. I'm phoning Uncle Harold. We're going to strike. We're going wildcat. I'm talking wildcat. Solidair, they'll back us 100%. The fairies will strike them. We'll eat quiche, wear women's clothing. I don't care. Let's save
Now, if they were smart, they'd get themselves a nice, cushy job with an independent production company.
And so Scrooge was alone again. But this was the thing he liked. Because for Scrooge, his fellow employees were mere surplus population. He had no use for any of them at any time, especially on December 25th.
Cratchit, Tiny Tim, good riddance. I don't need them. Christmas, humbug. I can run this place myself. Always have. Too many people around here. Management, unions, just gum up the works. Nobody knows what they're doing anyway. I don't need them. Management, too many people. Unions, not enough money. Not appreciated. I don't need them. Humbug.
In no time, Scrooge's bad humor had all but drained him, and he fell reluctantly into an uneasy sleep. Only to be awakened at the stroke of midnight.
Ebenezer.
Who said that? Who's there? You show yourself or I'll call a cop. Or worse, I'll call Ed Edwards.
Ebenezer Scrooge.
There stood the ghost of Jacob Marley, Scrooge's long-departed business partner, who had died 7 years ago this very night.
Marley, my old friend! I thought you were dead!
Not dead, Scrooge. I've been working in management.
But, why are you here? What do you want with me?
Scrooge, I'm here to warn you that this very night you will be visited by three ghosts. Beware, Scrooge. Beware.
Three ghosts? But why me, Marley? Why me?
I don't know, Scrooge. Somebody at Chan made the decision.
Geez, I don't know, Marley. What with Christmas and all, I'm kind of busy tonight. Maybe we could reschedule this.
Three ghosts, Scrooge. Beware. Beware. And get out of Newspar. Beware. Beware.
That Marley. He never was the same after he painted his face on that van.
Scrooge sat back in his chair, determined to wait out the arrival of his visitors.
Three ghosts, eh? I'll see if they show up. If they're like our production crew, they'll be 15 minutes late. Geez, I wonder if I could get them to paint the studio floor. Yeah, that Marley.
Sound.
ZCR down again.
What time is it?
To Scrooge's amazement, there before his sleepy eyes appeared a strange phantom. He carried on his shoulder a heavy weight and was bound from head to foot by cans and strips of film from some bygone era.
You got the wrong place, pal. We gave up shooting film years ago.
I am the ghost of Christmas past.
Ghost? Are you sure you're not something I ate?
Scrooge, I've come to show you Christmases of the past.
Whose past?
Your past, Scrooge, when you were a young reporter in his prime, a man at his peak.
I haven't peaked since Pamela Martin left.
Look upon yourself, Ebenezer. Behold, a young Scrooge.
Well, tie my face to the side of a pig and roll me in the mud. Ain't this weather strange?
Do you recognize yourself, Scrooge?
That's me, all right. Handsome devil, wasn't I?
Ooey, 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 ki-yi.
I really had a way with words back then.
Too bad they weren't English.
Okay, I don't have a watch, Bob. At least I do, too. It doesn't work, so fuck it.
Enough, Spirit, enough! The good old days are gone forever.
Over for you, Scrooge, but look upon those who have followed in your footsteps.
What's long and hard and yellow, surrounded by water and full of semen?
What's big, long, and green, surrounded by land, and has 620 people laid off?
And now you're ready to carve.
Spirit! Spirit!
The spirit had disappeared, leaving without a trace.
He's gone. Oh, must have been something I ate. A cup of coffee. That's what I need. A cup of coffee. I'll go get one, and I'll be happy.
With these purifying thoughts in mind, Scrooge made his way through the empty TV station en route to the staff lounge.
What do I do with this?
2 hours at 3:50.
But no sooner had he arrived at his destination when the room underwent a strange transformation. There on a stately couch sat a jolly giant, glorious to see.
Who are you?
Look upon me, Scrooge, for I am the ghost of Christmas present.
Funny, you look more like Liberace's houseboy.
Fa-la-la-la-la, Scrooge. You look like a centerfold for Field and Stream.
What do you want from me, Spirit?
Like I was saying, Scrooge, I'm the ghost of Christmas present, and I've come to show you what you're missing.
Missing? Like what?
Touch my robe, Scrooge, and follow me.
Okay, but as long as we're just friends.
Come on, Scrooge, and we'll fly around the station. Touch my robe and follow me.
I'm a stranger in paradise.
And so, the merry ghost led Scrooge down the hall into Czech television, Christmas, 1983.
Ho, ho, she seems like a pretty receptive chick.
Oh, she is, Scrooge. Don't worry. That's what all the boys in VTR say anyway. Oh, see?
She probably doesn't like Christmas. Hey, what's all this here? Is this where the buck stops?
This is a very important person. This is where everything gets vetoed.
Oh, this must be the Tid.
That's right, there he is, in all his tacky glory.
He probably doesn't like Christmas. Look at that. Technical mistake.
Problem
well,
there.
Mistake.
Call a tech, please.
He won't handle it. What's this guy? What's this guy on the phone doing on the phone? He's probably ordering Christmas stuff.
That's right, but the Christmas spirit's like that. You have to do that. You have to get on the phone and just be nice to people. Oh, there she goes. There goes the Newsroom 500.
She's pretty fast.
I think it's time for a pit stop.
Boy, now here's a real ghost.
Oh, this fella's happy too, except for his faulty tongue. And this guy too, he's happy.
These are far too happy. Oh my God, this looks like some sort of sales gathering. This looks like Watson's probably worried about his best buddy, Bishop.
He's cute. Look at all these cute people. Oh, they're so pretty. He's nice.
This is Twitchy Colburn in the background with Connectle and Hetherington.
Yes, but it's a fine looking...
Hope he gets a tie for Christmas.
It's a fine looking group though, Mike. Uh-oh, watch out. Half a cape.
Now, this isn't a Christmas carol. This is... Look, they don't like Christmas. These people,
she's happy. Come on, look, she's laughing. Oh, this person's laughing too. She's happy.
They have to work, don't you understand?
That's right, but they're still happy doing what they're doing. Oh, she's cute.
I kind of like her, I gotta admit.
She's very nice. Look, she's... Oh, now that's the Christmas spirit.
Wait a minute. We've had enough of this Christmas spirit. These people on the phone, I mean, they're working. That's the way it should be.
They're not working. They're not all working. Look, that man's not working. He's very happy.
Now, that's a technical error.
Oh, look at this fella. Small room, but he's still happy.
Because he thinks he knows everything. That's what his problem is.
Oh, now look at these people. These are some of the happiest people. See?
Come on. This is the only way they can get them to work there.
That's not true. That's not true at all.
It is the truth.
Look at that. Christmas spirit all the way. More Christmas spirit.
They're depressed. This is depressing me.
No, it's not depressing at all. Now, well, that's a little depressing, but not much.
Speaking of depressing, have you seen one of their newscasts?
Scrooge, just remember, if these images aren't altered in the future, Tiny Tim will undergo a sex change.
Oh my God, as long as they don't go on strike.
When Scrooge awoke, he found himself alone in the middle of the studio. The second ghost was gone. The station was empty again, lifeless.
5 o'clock. I must have dozed off again.
Well, I better get ready for sign-on. Cratchit will be here in about an hour.
It was just as Marley had predicted. A third vision had appeared, the ghost of the future. This was surely the spirit Scrooge feared more than any other.
So what do you think this is, American Bandstand? I've got work to do.
Well, don't give me that, you wimp. This dance ain't over until you've seen the future. Come on, Scrooge, let's 86 this joint.
Then Scrooge watched in amazement as the ghost produced a magical wand, and in an instant...
Hey, lady, are you coming?
Just a minute, bud. What a nerd. Get your hands off my thigh.
Scrooge followed the strange phantom into an unknown world of shadows. The city seemed to spring up about them, and suddenly they were greeted by a strange new vision.
Tell me, spirit. What does this image mean?
It's a future, Nimrod. I'm the third ghost, remember?
Where are we, Spirit? I must know.
This is Czech television of the future, Scrooge.
It's cold here, Spirit, and empty.
All the space you need, the latest equipment, cafeteria.
But, I don't like it here, Spirit. It's cold and dark. Take me back.
This is your new home, Scrooge. This is where you belong.
But we're all alone. Nobody else is here. We're alone.
You're alone, Scrooge. That's the way you wanted it, remember?
Yes. No. I mean, I don't want to be alone. I don't want to be alone.
So you finally got the point, Scrooge. A television station isn't cameras or fancy studios or high technology. It's people. People you work with every day. People like Bob Cratchit. People like you, Scrooge.
Like me?
Like you once were, Scrooge. It may be too late.
Spirit, I'll change. I'm a different man now.
You belong here alone, Scrooge.
I'll be better. I understand what Christmas is about now.
You belong here alone, Scrooge. Harold Harold from Chan will drop by once a month.
I'll change. Don't go. Don't leave me. I'm a better person now. I will change. I can change. I like Christmas. I'll change. I'm a better person. Please.
I'll change, Spirit.
Cratchit?
Look, Mr. Scrooge, it's 6 a.m. It's time for sign-on.
6 a.m.? What day is it?
Why, it's Christmas Day, Mr. Scrooge, and a Merry Christmas to you.
Christmas Day? Christmas Day! I've been given a second chance! The spirits have given me a second chance! God bless them! God bless you, Bob Cratchit! God bless you, Tiny Tim!
God bless us, everyone.
What a stupid thing to say.
Sorry, just slipped out.
Quick, Bob, we'll sign on with the Premier's message, and then I'll take us all out for a big Christmas breakfast!
Christmas breakfast, Mr. Scrooge? But...
No buts, Bob. You and the boys can order anything on the menu.
So where are you taking us to, Mr. Scrooge?
To the 7-Eleven.
What an asshole.
Here's the Premier's message now, Bob. As soon as we see this, then it's off for a big Christmas celebration!
Good evening. Tonight I'd like to talk about a topic that is of crucial importance to all of us. Most would agree that governments do not and cannot do the right thing. Businesses that are here will not long remain here. A new business will not locate in British Columbia. Our priority continues to be the bankruptcies and business failures. Since we became government, some 30 million people in the industrialized world are without work. If we've learned anything during the recession, it is that the only true job security, the BCGEU is the greatest single threat facing us. BCGEU problems, weaknesses, struck deep, struck swift. Being lean, being mean, tough times, firm. Softening or hardening of firm, mutual respect. Thank you, thank you, thank you, and good evening.
Scrooge was better than his word. He did change and became as good a man and as good a friend as that good old station ever knew or any other good old station in the good old world. And to Tiny Tim, who didn't go on strike, he was a second father. Scrooge stayed at Czech Television for another 20 years and eventually got a merit raise. And no matter what else was said about him, it was always said that Scrooge knew how to keep Christmas well. May that truly be said of all of us. God bless us, everyone.